Pollution drifting downstream. This time of year, we always see families out fishing and swimming on the South Platte River. However, in Greeley, your family could be swimming in wastewater.
A Greeley beef company is being sued now, accused of polluting the South Platte for years. Denver 7's Jessica Porter shows us just what's in the water.
Really, at its very core, you know, you wouldn't want to take what's left over from your supermarket meat counter and dump it into your swimming pool.
Ammonia, animal fat, blood, and excrement. That's what's in the wastewater from JBS Swift Beef, according to the Environmental Protection Agency.
For the past 4 years, JBS has been in violation of their Clean Water Act permit. Essentially, they've been dumping more things into Lone Tree Creek than they should. Or things that they shouldn't be dumping.
JBS operates in Greeley. It's required to treat their wastewater from the thousands of animals it slaughters each day and bring it under permitted toxicity levels before releasing it.
So essentially, they dump it into the creek and it flows downstream into, the Platte River, which is a major source of recreation for lots of families in the Greeley area.
The lawsuit points to EPA records, which show JBS has failed water toxicity tests for 5 years and even at times discharged unpermitted solids.
This stuff is toxic. It's not very good for aquatic species, for wildlife, and to be totally honest, it's gross.
JBS is a Brazilian-owned company and reported $49 billion in net revenue last year. The lawsuit comes as the company is under fire for taking $64 million in tariff bailout payments meant for hurting American farmers.
We see this all the time where multi-billion dollar corporations are the first in line to get bailed out when things go wrong. So at the end of the day, government bailout money is really designed to help, small farmers, family farmers. JBS shouldn't be receiving this money.
JBS sent us a statement promising they are working on making a change, saying they are, quote, committed to being good neighbors. We recently invested a significant amount to buy and install new blowers and provide oxygen to the wastewater treatment process, allowing us to further improve our process and ensure compliance. Future water tests will be needed to determine if their water treatment process has improved. Jessica Porter, Denver 7.
Now, JBS's permit to treat and release wastewater actually expired in 2017. Environmental groups now are pushing the court to stop them from violating water quality standards and adopt new practices.